Good morning. Today we are going to discuss the few problems in exercise 1.4, chapter 1. The first question is, without actually performing the long division, state whether the following rational number will have a terminating decimal expansion or a non-terminating decimal expansion. We should not divide this number by using long division method. Without doing that itself, we have to find out whether this rational number will have the terminating decimal expansion or the non-terminating decimal expansion. For solving this sum, we have to apply the theorems what we have learned in theorem 1.5, 1.6 and 1.7. Using these three theorem statements, we have to identify the given rational number has a terminating decimal expansion or the non-terminating decimal expansion. If the rational number has terminating decimal expansion, means then the denominator should be in the form of 2 power n and 5 power m. The prime factorization of this denominator should be in the form of 2 power n into 5 power m. If we have the denominator q in this form of 2 power n into 5 power m, where this n and m are non-negative integers, then we can say that this rational number has a terminating decimal expansion. Suppose if this denominator q does not have this format, that is, if the denominator q's prime factorization is not in the form of 2 power m into 5 power m, then it will have the non-terminating repeating decimal expansion. Now we have to see the q term in the given rational number, and we have to write the prime factorization of this q term and check whether it is in this format or not. Now let us start. Now 13 by 3125 is the given number. This is in the form p by q. Now take the q term. Q is equal to 3125. Go for prime factorization here. 3125. Let's solve in 5 table. 625. Again, let goes in 5. 1. Balance 1 will be there. 25. Again, 5 table. 2 5s are 10, then 5 5s are 25, and again 5 5. Now this 3125 can be written as 5 into 5 into 5 into 5 into 5. This is equal to 5 power 5. Now we have to check whether this is in the format of 2 power n into 5 power m. We have 5 power is there, 2 power is not there. So this can be written as q is equal to 3125. This is equal to 5 to the power 5. In this 2 is not there, therefore you can write this as 2 power 0. 2 power 0 value is 1. So 1 into 5 power 5, again it will be 5 power 5 only. Now which is in the form? N is equal to here 0 and M is equal to 5. This is in the form which is in the form 2 power N into 5 power M. So the rational number write the rational number 13 by 3125 has or will have terminating decimal expansion. Now let us go for the second example. Now this we have to check whether it has a terminating decimal expansion or non-terminating repeating decimal expansion. For that we have to go for check the prime factorization of q here. Now see that 450, 5 is there, go with 5 table, 9 5 is 45, 1 will be there. Now this will not go in 5, let us go with the 7, 13. So this can be written as 5 into 7 into 13. Now see that it should be in the form of 2 power n into 5 power m here. Now see here 2 is not there, 5 power m is there, but here extra terms of 7 and 13 is there. So this q is not in the form of 2 power n into 5 power m. Therefore the given rational number 64 by 4 455 will have a non-terminating repeating decimal expansion. See, in the first sum we have the q in the terms of 2 power n into 5 power m. So this rational number has terminating decimal expansion, but where in the case of second one this q is not in the form of 2 power m into 2 power n into 5 power m. Therefore this given rational number will have non-terminating repeating decimal expansion. Now let us see the second sum. Write the decimal expansion of those rational number which have the terminating decimal expansion. Now see here, for this one the given rational number is there. If this rational number is of the form 2 power n into 5 power m, if it is so, it has a terminating decimal expansion, then find the decimal expansion of the given rational number. First let us check whether this has a decimal expansion or not. After that we will go for writing what is that decimal number also. For checking that whether it has terminating decimal expansion, we have to go for taking the q value. See, this is in the form of p by q. Q should be in the form of 2 power n into 5 power m here. So q is equal to 3125. Go for prime factorization of q. So 3125, 5 table, 625, again 5, 25, 5 and 5. So this is equal to 5 into 5 into 5 into 5 into 5. This is equal to 5 power 5. Now we have to write this in terms of 2 power n into 5 power m. Here the term 2 is not there, so write that as 0, that is 2 to the power 0 into 5 to the power 5 here. N is equal to 0 and m is equal to 5. Now we found that yes, this is in the form of 2 power n into 5 power m. Therefore it has a terminating decimal expansion. The rational number 13 by 3125 will have terminating decimal expansion. Now let us find what is that decimal expansion here. See here, 13 by 3125, this is equal to 13 by this 3125, that is 3125 can be written as 5 power 5. Now see here, according to the theorem 1.6, if we want to convert it to the decimal format, means my denominator should be in terms of 10. Here already 5 is there. So to make it as 10, I need into 2 is there. So what power the 5 is having, the same power I have to give for this 2 also. Now what I have multiplied in the denominator, the same thing I have to do it in the numerator also. So multiply this by 2 power 5 and divide the same by 2 power 5. Now this is equal to 13 into 2 power 5 value is 32 divided by, this can be written as 10 the whole power 5. Now this is equal to 13 into 32, just multiply there, 13 into 32, the answer will be 416. Now take this value 416 divided by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 zeros are there. Now this we have to write it in the decimal format. So this is equal to, see here 3 decimals are there, here 5 zeros are there. So 4, 1, 6, 3 places is there, remaining 2 zeros. So put the 2 zeros in the front there and keep the point here. Now see here 0.00416 is the decimal expansion for 13 by 3125. Now let us go for the next one, that is 35 by 50. Now this is in the form of P by Q here. Now we have to write the prime factorization of this P and Q. So P by Q is equal to P value is 35. So prime factorization of 35, 5 table 7, 7 table 1. So this can be written as 5 into 7 divided by 50. For 50, write as 5, here 10, then again 5, here 2, 2, 1. So 5 into 5 into 2. Now these two will get cancelled here. Now see here, this is equal to 7 by 5 to the power 1 into 2 to the power 1. Now the denominator Q, already I got the format of 2 power n into 5 power m there. So it is in the terms of 10 only. So we can write this as 7 by 10. So the decimal expansion for 35 by 50, this is equal to 0.710 is there. So after one decimal we have to keep the point, so the value is 0.7. Now let us do the third sum. The following real number have the decimal expansion as given below. In each case, decide whether they are rational or not. If they are rational and of the form P by Q, what can you say about the prime factors of Q? Now see here, they have given the decimal expansion of the number. First, we have to check whether it is a rational number or not. After checking that it is a rational number, then we have to go for the P by Q form of the rational number. After writing the P by Q of the rational number, what we can say about the prime factors of Q, that for the all the three questions we have to answer here. The first question given here is 43.12345678. See here, after decimal I have 9.9 numbers here. After this decimal places, I have 9 numbers here. Now, see, this number stops here. It does not keep on moving. They have not kept the dot. If the dot is there, it is understood that the number keeps on moving. But the number stops at the digit, 9th digit there. So, it has the terminating decimal expansion. From this we can see that it is a terminating decimal expansion. That is, the remainder becomes zeros when the 9th digit is there. So Now, this has a terminating decimal expansion, means this can be expressed in the form of P by Q. Now, this is a terminating decimal expansion. Now, this we have to write in the form of P by Q. See, after decimal, how many numbers are there? 9 numbers are there. So, this can be written as 43, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 divided by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 zeros we have to write here. Now, this is equal to 43, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9 divided by 10 to the power 9. Because 9 zeros are there, so we can write this as 10 to the power 9. Now, 10 power 9 means this can be written as 43, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 divided by 10 can be split into the prime factors of this 10 are 2 and 5, the whole power 9. Now 2 have the power 9 and 5 have the power 9 there. Now the denominator Q, that is the prime factors of Q, are in the form of 2 power n into 5 power m there. This is a value of P and this is a value of Q. This is in the form of 2 power n into 5 power m. Here P is equal to 43, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and Q is equal to 2 power 9 into 5 power 9. This is in the form 2 power n into 5 power m. Now, go for the second sum. It is 0.12012001200000. Keeps on going. See here, if this symbol is there, the number keeps on moving there and it does not follow any pattern here, means then this is not a terminating number and this is not the repeating number also. So this number is not a rational number itself. This is an example for the irrational number. See, this decimal expansion is neither terminating nor non-terminating repeating. Therefore, it is not a rational number. So it is not a rational number means then this is an example for irrational number. Now let us go for the third sum. See, the question is 43.12345678 9, the whole bar is there. Now we have to check whether it is a rational number or not. See, the decimal expansion, after decimal I have 9 numbers there and I have a bar over this 9 numbers. This bar indicates that a certain block of numbers keeps on repeating. Here the set of 9 numbers keeps on repeating. See, here the decimal expansion does not terminate here. It is a non-terminating number and the quotient keeps on repeating there. Remainder does not become 0 and quotient keeps on repeating. Therefore, this is a This is a non terminating repeating number. Now see here, if it is a non terminating and repeating means, then this is a rational number. Once we know that it is a rational number means, we can able to write this in the form of P by Q. That is P by Q, this is equal to X, that X is a given number 43.123456789 keeps on moving there. Now see here, we have already learned in the class 9 there, if the decimal expansion keeps on repeating, we know how to represent that non-terminating repeating number in the form of P by Q. Now what is the procedure we have to follow here? After decimal, how many numbers are repeating here? 9 numbers are repeating. So let us take this X as the first equation. Now here 9 numbers are repeating, so multiply this both the sides by 10 to the power 9 here. So multiply both sides by 10 to the power 9 in this equation 1. If it is so, see here, now 10 power 9x is equal to 439 into 10 power 9 means 9 digit will move this side and again this number will be there. So this is 43123456789. Again this set keeps on repeating here. Now let us take this one as a second equation. Now solve the first and the second. 2 and 1 here. Let us subtract these two. Subtract 2 minus 1. So 10 power 9 x equal to 43123456789.123456789 keeps on moving minus first equation x equal to, see here 43 is the number there, so 43.123456789 this keeps on moving. Now subtract these two, after decimal everything got 0 here, so total it got delete here. Now this will become 43123456746. Here this becomes here. See here, 10 to the power 9x is there. From that 1x, if it got cancelled. Now this side. Now see here, 10 to the power 9x minus 1x, only 1 got subtracted means 9 times you will get the 9 here. Now x value is equal to, x you keep it this side, this you take it to the next side, 43123456746 divided by 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.